हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू शॉर्ट एंड सुपर फास्ट राइटर्स। दोस्तों, आप चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करें और बेल आइकन को दबाएं डेली शॉर्ट एंड डिक्टेशंस के लिए। आज की डिक्टेशन वॉल्यूम नंबर 8, ट्रांसक्रिप्शन नंबर 166 से। बी रेडी, 10 सेकेंड्स, 5 सेकेंड्स, स्टार्ट। आई शुड लाइक टू डील ओनली विथ सम इम्पॉर्टेंट डिपार्टमेंट्स। आई शैल टेक फर्स्ट द डिफेंस डिपार्टमेंट। द एलोकेशन टू द डिफेंस डिपार्टमेंट विच इन द बजट ऑफ द लास्ट ईयर वॉज ₹800 करोर्स has been reduced to about ₹700 crores. Is it because the defense requirements have diminished in number? I have come to know that recruitment to the forces has been stopped. At what number has it been stopped? In the present emergency, soon after the incursion of the Chinese, it was hoped that our defense forces would be raised to the number of 2 million. Has at least 1 million been reached so far? The war with China can never be considered to be a war of limited liability. Modern wars are wars of unlimited liability, and we cannot say that recruitment of 500,000 troops would be just enough to meet the requirements of national defense. For let us remember that there are not 2 fronts, the Ladakh front and the Arunachal front, that we have to deal with, but there is the Pakistan front also that we have to contend with, and the Pakistan front consists of 2 fronts, one on the west and one on the east. I should like the Defense Ministry to consider whether the recruitment so far attained is enough to meet our defense requirements on all these 4 fronts. Then, in regard to weapons, I find no provision is made for the manufacture of machine guns, which are so necessary in modern warfare, especially to stop the incursion of large masses of troops, such as we experienced at the time of the Chinese incursion on the Arunachal border. We have been promised that in course of time the naval defense would be supplied with that modern weapons of defense, namely the submarine. To this end, officers have been sent to the United Kingdom to learn how to handle submarines. I hope and trust that very soon we shall acquire at least 2 submarines. I would suggest that the useless aircraft carrier, which serves no defense purpose at all at present, upon which ₹30 crores were spent and the maintenance of which comes to about 6 crores of rupees a year, might be sold to some power that requires an aircraft carrier, and the amount thus realized might be spent on the purchase of submarines. Mr. Vice Chairman, I now come to another important department, the Department of External Affairs, which also swallows a large part of the budget. We have as many as 129 million. We have had these missions for the past 15 years, and I think it is time that the External Affairs Ministry began to consider the question whether all these 129 missions are required. Why do we want missions in Latin American countries, which have no political, diplomatic or international connection with India? For trade purposes, certainly we should have some representatives, but then consular officials would be enough for this purpose, and we need not maintain these costly embassies and missions in the countries of Latin America. Looking at the report of the Ministry of External Affairs, I find a reference made to relations with foreign powers. Relations with Afghanistan and Myanmar, our immediate neighbors, our near neighbors, are reported to be friendly. About Pakistan, nothing is said about relations. The obvious inference is that the relations are not friendly. But what about the countries of Southeast Asia? These are countries with which we should have friendly relations, but there is no reference at all in the report to the relations, whether friendly or hostile, with the Southeast Asian countries. For the defense of India and for the defense of the whole South Asia, especially Southeast Asia, friendly relations with the Southeast Asian countries are absolutely necessary. In order to establish these friendly relations with foreign countries, visits of important persons from the president downwards have been arranged, but what are our missions doing in several countries in order to maintain and promote friendly relations with India? Are they allowed to take initiative? Are they allowed to be active in the promotion of friendly relations, or are they to be content merely with carrying out the orders from the Ministry of External Affairs? What information, diplomatic, economic, military, do these missions abroad convey to India? For instance, in regard to the Chinese invasion of India, was the military attaché able to send useful reports upon the military situation, upon the military intentions of China? It is no doubt difficult in totalitarian countries, in communist countries, for foreign missions to get enough information, but from the experience of missions maintained by the United Kingdom, by the United States of America, these countries are able to get valuable military and other useful information from their representatives abroad? Or is it the fact that our military attaches, commercial attaches, send reports to our ministries, but the External Affairs lay these reports aside? The next item of expenditure which has attracted my notice is the expenditure on pension. As much as 100 crores of rupees have been allotted for payment of pensions and other relief. May I once more point out to the Finance Ministry the leadership which people who have commuted their pension are suffering from. Some of the people who have commuted their pension have had the misfortune to live up to 70 to 80 years and have paid their commuted portion twice, and still this government exacts these payments from these commuted pensioners. I think the time has come when the Finance Ministry should look sympathetically at the lot of the commuted pensioners and restore the original pension at least 5 to 6 years after they have paid up the full commuted amount. Then I come to that white elephant in our government, namely the Planning Commission, which costs us rupees 1000 crores on a former occasion when I made the remark that our Planning Commission is the costliest in the world. The Minister of State for Finance said that the French Planning Commission was as large, if not larger, and it was costly as our Planning Commission. Thanks for watching. Do subscribe and don't forget to like.